Hi, my name is Michael Schmidt. I'm the chief scientist at Datarobot. Today I'll be talking about time series forecast. Time series modeling is one of the hardest problems in data science because you're trying to take recent history and predict what's going to happen next. So let's look at an example time series data set. So time series data sets mean that you're tracking multiple signals over time. So a simple example might be just tracking the sales of a product or the sales for a store. And you might have data that looks like this, that you're tracking up to a certain point. So let's call this now, for example. So based upon this recent history, what you'd like to do is use that to train a model that tells you what will happen next. So we'd like to be able to extend this line and say, this is what we think the sales are gonna be. Are they gonna go up, are they gonna go down, or are they gonna flatten out? So there's endless use cases where this can be extremely valuable to know. And it's a really hard problem to do because you need to look back at this history and make the most accurate guess or prediction of what happens next. So one of the reasons why time series modeling is so hard and so difficult is there's many different types of time series data sets, and that was just one of them. So let me show you a couple others. So you might have some that look like this, where there's a trend with some periodic variation, right? So another example might be one that has no periodic variation. So you might have one that looks like this, right? But it has some growth over time. A third type you might be interested in is something like sensor data, where it's a stationary signal, but it has some variation going on, and you'd like to be able to anticipate what happens on this type of data set as well. So given these different flavors of problems, you would typically treat these very differently. You would take different approaches, you'd build different types of models. And what we need to be able to do is build a system that can identify what's the right approach to take, what's the right algorithm, what are the right features to engineer in order to give you the highest possible predictive accuracy for these problems.